accomplish those things that they believe in. So. Goes like this. Oh.
pleasure of introducing to you a very special man of song, a legend among folk musicians, who will sing his own composition, Peace Will Come, and we know it will, Mr. Tom Paxton.
who just gave an outstanding performance in Armenia. And I'm hoping that I'll say a few words to the folks at home on, while we have it here on camera. We loved your performance, and we're here for peace. And I'd like to know what inspired you to come out.
Any chance that we can have the opportunity to encourage peace, you know, for everybody, for our neighbors, for our children, and music is a wonderful vehicle for that, because it gives people quite a joyous feeling. It goes a long way.
It certainly does, and the audience was very inspired. I know, speaking of inspiration, you mentioned that you have a new album out. Maybe you could let the folks at home know what it is.
Yeah, it's called The Earth Press Flat. You can get it in any store.
So this one.
And it actually came out last year, and it's on Far None Records, or you can order it from our webpage, www.maniacs.com.
Excellent. I'm sure many people will tap that up. They want to know more about you, and I know you've been around for a long time. You were mentioning off camera that it's been around how long?
This September will be our 19th anniversary.
That's amazing. And you've all been together, or do you have some new members?
Well, the boys in the band have been together since the beginning, and we have a new singer, although she's been playing with us since 1990, but she's been in the band since 94, Mary Ramsey.
Oh, and there's Mary over there.
Very maybe feeling with a camera.
Look at the shot of Mary. I'm looking at you. Mary.
Looking good.
Allergy.
Mary's looking great. Mary, can you tell us a little bit about your thoughts? I did ask that. Did that make you feel it? I hope I didn't.
Did you ask?
Yes, I did. I asked one of the male members. I'd like to get the female members' thoughts on peace.
It's pretty simplistic, but I just feel like times that are peaceful are when people are doing things naturally to them. When you're sleeping, or when you're around children and they're happy, or when you're breathing, or you see birds, and you see the sky, and you see the environment, just as it should be, without a lot of conflict. I mean, conflict is horrible too, but I think that starting at that point is like something, you know, starting at the lowest common denominator, or the most simplistic place is the best way to understand peace, understand what happens, to make it a little bit more, to happen more often in life. Understanding how that happens, and you feel it, and you find it, and then trying to keep repeating those things. If everybody did it, I mean, it's like the whole thing, it starts with it. Well, I think a lot of people will agree with your words there.
I didn't say too profoundly.
Oh, I think you did. You were just great. I appreciate your time. Thank you. And I also wanted to mention just what an outstanding player. Thank you. And we got it on camera, and the folks at home will be able to see. I wish everyone could be here. You were great.
Thank you.
And we wish you good luck.
That's very nice to hear. I'll keep that in my home peace bang here.
Great. Thanks. And how old were you?
Five.
Five when you started. That's just amazing. And your performance was outstanding. What about singing? What about singing? Are you into gospel music at all?
No,
do you have any of that kind of background?
I don't like gospel music. I don't.
You don't, really?
No.
Then focus.
I know too much about it, man. I've seen too much of it. I've seen what it does to people. I've seen how phony the people can be in gospel.
Really?
That's right. You got, just like the Indian once said, you got a forked tongue and two faces.
Now, was your father a professional musician? Or
no, my daddy was a railroad man on the Southern Pacific in Texas. Railroad.
And that's where you grew up in Texas?
Yeah.
And you're on the road now. How old were you when you went on the road as a musician?
Oh, I didn't go on the road till about 36. I was really young then.
Where do you call home now?
I live in Louisiana.
Louisiana?
Yeah, Slidell.
How long are you on the road? Are you on the road most of the year or home often?
I'm on the road, baby. 250 days a year.
You must look forward to getting back to Louisiana. When will you be going back?
Well, I'll go back in 10 days and rest. I just come for home. For 4 days. When we were in Colorado, me and my band flew back to Louisiana. We were at home. Mm-hmm. For 4 days, we left that Friday. Headed for Boston. I flew into Boston.
All right, thank you so much.
Well, we really enjoyed you when you're ready. Leo really wants to know who you've played with in the past.
No, I don't know, several people.
Any names that we'd recognize or the folks at home would recognize?
I guess.
Well, we recognize you.
All right.
And that's all that's important.
That's all that's important.
And thanks so much for giving us the time.
All right.
Thank you.
So anyway, I guess that's it. The reason's all legitimate. I don't know how well I can fit inside this. 'Cause I've been thinking every night since then. I'm tripping over it again. I managed to pick up a pen and write this. See, I'm overwhelmed. I'm overcome. And maybe I was nothing more than everyone who came before. And maybe you mistook my door for an exit. But you're not the only one to blame. Us others, we have done the same. And every heart will speak a name that brings it. See, I'm overcome. See, I'm overtaxed. See, I'm undermined. See, I am. See, I am. Guess I'll miss your easy pace, the way your hair falls in your face, the way that you touch all the space around you. And I suppose I'm more on the loss of love, the future I've been dreaming of everything I found because I found you. I suspect I know the roads to take. I set myself, avoid mistakes. A list of points that I can break it down to. See, I'm overwhelmed. See, I'm overwrought. See, I'm overworked. See, I'm out of breath. See, I'm out of sorts. See, I'm out of time. See, I.
fighting. One of the things that I'd like her to share with you is where she was last night. Kelly, where were you?
Last night I was at a competition in Barre, Vermont, and it was a New England competition for fiddle.
Yeah, and Callie, how did you do?
I came in fourth.
Wow, congratulations.
Thank you.
Now, how long have you been fiddling?
I started classical violin in public school when I was in second grade, so I've been doing classical violin for, I think I'm going on my sixth year, but I started doing fiddle 3 years ago, I think.
Wow, you're very accomplished. Do you still play classical violin?
Yes.
Yes? And what is your dream musically? Do you have a dream? Or are you living it right now? Is this what you want?
I guess I'm living it right now. I don't really have to think. Thank
you. See, I'm overwhelmed. See, I'm overwrought. See, I'm overworked. See, I'm out of breath. See, I'm out of sorts. See, I'm out of time. See, I am. See, I am. I'm
Thank you. pieces, they are long pieces. Indian classical music involves the playing of ragas. The first raga is called Rag Durga. We're going to start with very traditional Indian classical music played in the style of Amjad Ali Khan, who's my teacher. And then we're going to do a fusion piece with Gus on sax and Tip joining us on Dolik. So stick around, it's very peaceful music, and I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. Thank you.
Entertainment, Andrew Mark and Fred Kosak, and they play music, jazz, funk. And the name of your group is The Bread. And you're two members of the group playing. You have a larger group that you usually play with?
In Montreal.
In Montreal, we have a band, we're not really a part of that as a project. That's kind of a different feel and different sound, but our band up there is called Euphoric Side Effects.
And how many members do you have in that group?
Four of us.
Quartet.
Four of you. Uh-huh.
Yep.
What kind of music do you play with that group?
That's more, I guess, in the same vein. It's just got a different sound. It's with a drum set.
Yeah, you know, it's a big sound.
It's a big sound. Yeah.
And certainly wouldn't fit in this place.
Oh, yeah,
which is
much
kind of small.
We kind of cut it down.
We play clubs up there.
Oh, so it's very different.
Yep.
Now, the two of you have been playing regularly here this summer?
Yeah, we've been playing for a while.
Well, you have a nice following. The place is full. Everybody seems very enthusiastic.
Yeah, it's been good. Friends turn out.
Friends
family,
have come and some new friends, I think, too.
Yep.
Now, you've been playing since you were kids. Together.
Well, together.
Define kids.
Well, when I think of kids, I think of teenagers, early teenagers.
Ninth grade.
Yeah.
So you were about 14 when you started playing together?
Yeah, around there, 14, 15. Been playing for 4 or 5 years.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Now, are you going to pursue a music career, or is this, how are you feeling about it?
I don't know. It depends on how things work out.
Depends on how it goes, yeah. Mm-hmm. Thinking about doing it all through college, that's for sure.
It wouldn't be a bad existence.
No.
So, you know, if we could work it out that way.
It'd be a lot of fun.
Yeah.
To the L.A. Steel Show. I'm here in Canaan, Connecticut at Railroad Days. Sitting beside me is Joseph Firecrow. Welcome to the show, Joseph.
It's good to be here.
Thank you. And I wanted to hear a little bit about your music. I know you play Native American music. Do you also play a mix of modern with it?
Yes, I do. The traditional music, it comes from my people. Mm-hmm. It comes from my elders. And some of these songs are very, very old. And they're social in nature, so I can share them with people. And also, combining it with the modern or contemporary sound has been it's been happening ever since the Europeans have come here.
Mm-hmm.
with their music. And today we're recognized at the highest levels in the music industry for our music and for our talent, and it's a wonderful thing.
I understand you've received several awards, and what were they? What were they for?
Well, I received a Telly Award back in '99 for a song called "Wind in My Mind," I think.
Was that a song you wrote?
The song I wrote, and it was a score for a cable award, non-network cable award, and then I was nominated for a Grammy in 2001. And the same year, I was nominated for Artist of the Year and Flautist of the Year for the Native American Music Awards.
All in 2001?
Yes.
That was a banner year for you.
Yes. The title of the album was called Cheyenne Nation. I didn't get a lot of recognition, and it's a great album.
Now, that's a CD, and you have other CDs as well?
Yes. I have 5 solo CDs, solo albums. And the latest one was released in March of this year,
mm-hmm.
Titled Legends of the Warrior. And we covered some of those songs tonight with the traditional music. And flute making goes back centuries in my people, and the songs that come with the flutes have been there all along. And you make the flutes out of the very center of the juniper tree.
Now this is something that you actually do. You make
yes.
your own flutes.
Yes, I make my own flutes. And if I'm making a traditional flute, I will get the wood from back home in Montana. I will look for a certain tree called the juniper tree.
Mm-hmm.
I will find it and I'll ask the tree permission, can I use it in a good way? And then I will use all of the tree, and I'm looking for the very heartwood of the tree. And long ago, we didn't have measuring instruments,
mm-hmm.
The basic flute was the length of from your elbow to the tips of your fingers.
And you have many that you play when you perform?
Yes, I play some of the flutes that I make myself, but I also, there's great flute circles across the country, and we share information, we share
mm-hmm.
flute design,
mm-hmm.
and we give flutes to one another, so I do play flutes from others.
Now, you said you have several solo CDs as
yes.
well as you play with the band. Do you play with the same band?
No. It depends on the project itself. And playing live music is a bit different than you're being a recording artist in a studio.
Mm-hmm.
They're two different animals, so to speak. And it's nice to get out there and do the live stuff.
I was born into the people back on the reservation. I was given 2 names. I was born into the Firecrow family. Ohkiotst is how we pronounce that. I was given the name Joseph. That is, I would say, a regular name. And then I was given what I considered my real name. It is my Cheyenne name. And this name ties me to the land. It ties me to my people. It ties me to centuries upon centuries of tradition and culture. It is still rich and vibrant to this very day. My Cheyenne name is Hospinahko. Hospinahko. And I'm going to tell you the literal translation in English. The literal translation is somewhere between imitation, trying to become, to imitate, but unsuccessful at it. Unsuccessful Bear is my Cheyenne name. Hospinako. I'm trying to become a bearer, but I can't quite do it. And I asked about this. An old man, Peter Bear, comes out, gave this name to me. He is my father's uncle. So he's my grandfather. And that name came from his grandfather, Hospinako. It is important for us to have these things. To us being Cheyenne is this. Centuries ago, we live it today. Generations from now, we still live it right now. In the past and future, this is who we are. And it's hard to translate that. We will sing for everyone. It is a song of life and of happiness when we come together for the round dance. We will dance in the circle and we will hold hands. March, we release an album called Legend of the Warrior. My record company, Makoche, did a fine job. My hat is off to David Swenson for the wonderful arrangements he made, as well as getting it ready for everyone. And I'm going to play a couple songs off of that in the course of the evening, and you may recognize some songs. I'm going to play for you a flute piece, and if some of you don't know, I'm a flute man, and that means that I not only make flutes with my own hands, I don't use electricity unless I'm using a light to see what I'm doing. I also know I play them, but I also know the songs that come with these flutes, and I'm also recognized by my elders back in Lame Deer, Montana, as a flute man. There's not many of us. And I'm going to explain a little bit about that to you and the songs that come with it. And we call them wolf songs. They are songs of love and affection that we have for one another. And we're using these wolf songs and we're combining them today beautifully. The name of this song is called Sweet Medicine. Sweet Medicine was a prophet of the people. He taught us, he brought us from our primitive ways, and he taught us how to become the human beings, how to be human beings, to treat each other in a good way. He taught us many songs, and he gave us societies. He gave us structure. He also gave us ceremony to honor him, the prophet of the Northern Cheyenne people. Sweet Medicine. It's a traditional piece on the flute, and I hope you enjoy it.
We ain't high. Social songs. They come from Happy's people.
Haudenosaunee people. They call us Iroquois people today, but we call ourselves Haudenosaunee, which is an Onondaga word. In my language, it would be Haudenosaunee or Gunnanosaunee, which means people who build longhouses. But it's kind of a metaphor. What the longhouse represented to us was a house of peace. So actually, it's people who build houses of peace. Like, that's what we call ourselves. Our greeting, where I'm from, a slang greeting would be Sego Skana Goaga, which is, again, I wish you great peace. A more higher form of hello would be Watkanua Ladu, with all my heart, my love to you. So when I was growing up, I didn't quite understand when I read all these history books and they said my people were such a warrior people, or that we lived and thrived off of warfare, when we talked in the opposite way of war. It was always in peace and always to reason out. And I remember growing up back home, and seeing in a longhouse a political structure which never allowed you to raise your voice or to get too angry or too mad, or they would put it away for the next day. So that's something that I seen growing up. So to me, politics is a very, very beautiful thing. That's two groups of people or two nations trying to work it out in a very peaceful way.
again.